Wine consumption has increased by the billions of bottles in recent years, thanks partly to pop culture making it the hip drink for young people. The bottom feeders, though, in the wine industry, not the entire industry, but the bottom feeders have taken advantage of this, and they're cutting corners to raise their profits. Joining me now for more of that is Mike Burg. Michael, I'm interested to know where things are now. We're 3 weeks into the lawsuit that you've brought against, not the wine industry, by the way. I want to point out, you did not bring a case against the wine industry. You brought a case against what I call the bottom feeders of that industry. Now, every industry has its bottom feeders. I mean, whatever you're talking about, you got the people at the bottom that are trying to do things cheaply, make the most money, and take advantage of everybody in the process. And I just saw, I don't know if you've seen these statistics, in the last 3 years, wine consumption has increased by 2 billion bottles of wine more than it was just years before. So in other words, this new culture is developing around wine, and people simply don't know how dangerous the bottom end of it, the what I call the bottom feeders, are where it comes to serving up wine.
It's amazing. You know, one of the things and the reason people are drinking more wine is there's all these studies that have come out that what wine is healthy for you, that wine can be healthy for you. And you know what? Those studies are true. The problem is in this class of wine, it's not true because of the amount of arsenic that's in there. I think it's important for the public to understand what we're talking about. I want you to think of 1 billion molecules, 1,000 million. Molecules. And of that, the World Health Organization and the EPA says you can only have, for it not to be beyond the dangerous level, 10 out of 1 billion. And so that tells you how poisonous arsenic is throughout.
Okay, so in other words, the World Health Organization has looked at this. The United States has looked at this. NIOSH has looked at it. Scientists in America. And out of, now again, that's a good way to put it. If you can visualize 1 billion molecules, they're saying in water, if you get 10. If you get 10 molecules of arsenic in that billion, you're putting your health at risk.
Correct. Per day. Okay. Some of these wines, and I use that term very loosely, have 5 times that. So you're talking about a very high poisonous level. Now, what's really interesting about it is that when you talk about bottom feeders and you talk about the wine industry, anyone who's gone to Napa, if you go through almost every of the wineries, they show you how meticulous they are. And these winemakers really are very looking for quality in their wine. That's not the people we're suing. The real vintners, the real winemakers, they're making sure that the arsenic levels are not in a dangerous level. The people we're going after are the people who are putting, number one, arsenic into their wine, from this goo that we talked about that they mix in there, and also for clarifying on the white wines. And so what we're talking about, people who are really renegades, they're not winemakers. These are people who are out there just to make a quick buck, do it as cheaply as possible, and get it out to the public.
Okay, they have their, you know, I call them flying monkeys. They have their flying monkeys out already in blogosphere. And one thing that flying monkeys are talking about is, oh, gee whiz, arsenic is ubiquitous. We're not talking about ubiquitous arsenic here. We're talking about man-made. The only way, the only place this comes from is man-made, and it's not organic arsenic. Is that right?
Well, there is some organic arsenic in there. That's going to happen. But the majority of the arsenic that we found when we did our third testing, the majority of it is inorganic, which is, the experts say, is between 300 and 500 times more dangerous. So we're looking at the total content of arsenic. Some of, you know, they want to say, well, this is ubiquitous. First of all, any toxicologist, and we've talked to them, epidemiologists, they'll say, you want no arsenic in your wine. Let's start there. You want no arsenic in your wine, but you're going to have some because of what you talked about, the ubiquitous arsenic that's in the ground. But beyond that, these people, the majority of the arsenic we're finding, because we did the test, is not that kind of arsenic. This is pesticides. This is poison. These are things that have been added that have not been filtered out. The key here, and the public should understand, that whether it's Gallo or whether it's Screaming Eagle at the top, they filter it out. They make sure that the arsenic levels in their wines do not have levels that are beyond the recommended amount by the World Health Organization, by the United States government, by the state of California. They make sure through the filtering process, as well as the way they make the wine, that they don't have these problems. The winemakers that we sued, they quite frankly have not done it. They don't care about it. They want to fight about, well, whether it's arsenic. First of all, the question becomes for the viewers, do you want to know how much arsenic is in your wine? And I would think, knowing how poisonous it is, that every consumer wants to know.
Okay, but right now they fought even labeling that on the bottle. They won't even mention, oh, by the way, we have 50 times the safe level of arsenic in our wine. I mean, obviously, if you saw that, you may as well see a skull and crossbones. But so, okay, here's what I see happening here. It looks like the bottom feeders of the wine industry, not the wine industry, but the very worst of that of the wine industry, has already gone out and they've paid off scientists. They've paid off people to write articles that we're finding out they're not even being written by the people who are signing off on the article that says, look, there's nothing to all this. These articles are already showing up because they know that for the right price, they can hire these biostitutes to say there's nothing to this. We saw it with tobacco, right?
Right.
We saw tobacco. The biostitutes lined up by the thousands saying, no, tobacco won't cause cancer. Tobacco's not addictive. Tobacco won't cause emphysema. Remember that? I remember because I handled the case.
Yep.
Okay, so all of a sudden, we're seeing the same thing happening with wine. What's your take on it?
Well, you know, it's going to happen. We've been in this business long enough that they have the money and the ability to hire people to say whatever they want. But it's really off base here because what they're saying are two things. Number one, they're saying, don't worry about it. It's not going to hurt you. Well, you know, all you got to do is talk to a real toxicologist. And even they have to admit, arsenic is poison. It is poison. There's no doubt about that. And we go throughout history, look at all the leaders that were killed by arsenic poisoning. I even have to laugh, arsenic and old lace. The old ladies were putting the arsenic in the elderberry wine in that play in 1944. Guess
Napoleon
what?
Napoleon Bonaparte. Right? Yeah.
Bonaparte was killed. So we know that's wrong. They're wrong there. Arsenic is not safe. Number two, they say, well, we're comparing it to drinking water. Fine, that's okay. You shouldn't have arsenic in your drinking water. And quite frankly, you shouldn't have high levels of arsenic in your wine. One has nothing to do with the other. And the third thing they say, which is basically, we're scaremongering. We're making the consumer afraid. And you know what? We're not making anybody afraid. What we want to talk about is choice. If you put the amount of arsenic that you have in your wine, and you're willing to sell it to the public, even though you know the health risks, put it on there and let the public decide. Do you want to buy the bottle of wine that has high level of arsenic, or do you want to buy the wine that doesn't? And I think the public's going to buy the wine that doesn't.
Mike, isn't there a new website that's developing? There's a couple of websites. What are they that people can go and they don't have to listen to your opinion or my opinion. They can read it. Where do they go?
Well, let me first of all, Taint and Wine is a website that's part of the organization. But I also want to tell you, I want to give a plug to Gray. The Gray Report, he is probably the highest, most well-known blogger in the wine industry. I read his report last night. He really made a good point, which was, what does the wine industry really want to do? Do you want to defend the bottom feeders? Do you really want to defend them? Or do you want to get them out of the business or make them do it right? And he talked about Gallo, which we've tested numerous of their bottles in the same price point. They don't have excess arsenic in there.
They do it right. Gallo does it right, for example.
Exactly. Exactly. Okay. They get it out. And he also said, why is the Wine Institute? Why would the Wine Institute put the winemakers who are truly, truly proud of their product, who are truly making wine to make it the best it can be, make sure that it's safe, and it's beautiful, and it has a great nose, and it's really wonderful. Why do those vintners want to protect these people who don't even make wine the right way? They're not interested in the quality of the wine. They're just interested in making money, regardless of the amount of arsenic and the health risks with regard to
their
wines.
Mike, real quick, there's something called, you go to forcechange.com.
Oh, I saw it.
It's forcechange.com.
Sign the
and
petition.
These are just citizens that say, you know, we want to know how much arsenic is in our, right. is in our wine.
There's a petition. They have a petition, right. Forcechange.com. They have a petition. People should sign it if you want to make sure that the wine industry gets the arsenic out and have to tell the public how much the arsenic is in there. We have nothing to do with that website. These are consumers. These are customers who drink wine who are concerned.
Yeah. All right. Michael, we're out of time. Keep the pressure up, okay?
Thanks, Mike.
A lot.
Appreciate it.
Bye. Bye-bye.